I just learned to do the best I could with what I had. There were so many little things that you just couldn't do anymore because of the tremor. I first noticed the tremor in my right hand when I was about 17. I was taking a welding course and couldn't hold an electrode steady, maybe 50. I started noticing that when I would try to eat, my hand would shake, and it got to where I couldn't write anymore.
He's always been great at taking pictures. We have some amazing pictures that he has taken over the years and sent to me while he was driving the semi. All of a sudden, he'd pull off somewhere and I'd have a mountain scene come across. But you could see in later time that movement.
I couldn't hold a camera steady. The shaking was just made it impossible.
We always assess patients who have tremor by observing under what conditions the tremor is present. Now, in the case of Mr. Hiner, he was strongly dominant for one of his limbs, and so what he really needed was one good limb that didn't shake in order to carry out his normal activities of daily living. The first approach was to manage his tremor with drugs, and frequently this is ineffective, as it was in his case, and so he was then a candidate for either deep brain stimulation or HIFU. And then ultimately, a multidisciplinary team of experts came to the conclusion that HIFU would be the ideal treatment for him.
When I met Mr. Hiner, one of his concerns was that his tremor was affecting everything he did. He couldn't eat, he couldn't go out in public, he couldn't drink water. He wasn't interested in an invasive procedure. MR-guided high-intensity focused ultrasound is a procedure that focuses ultrasound beams across an intact skull onto parts of the brain to treat neurological and psychiatric diseases. There's no anesthesia, there are no incisions, and there's no implantable hardware.
We couldn't get there fast enough and was not even concerned when he was back there that this wasn't going to be a 100% success.
On the day of the procedure, we did another neurological assessment, drawing spirals, doing a test called finger to nose, where you just put your finger out and have them touch your finger and touch their nose and go back and forth, and then holding his hand right in front of his nose for as long as he can. So people with essential tremor, when they start to do these things, their tremor starts getting significant. We are one of two centers in the country that are using four-tract-based tractography. What that means is we're looking at cables in the brain and identifying what the target is in that individual versus using landmark-based methods or measuring approximate distances from pieces of the brain. We gave about 7 or 8 ultrasound treatments, and when we walked in at the very end, his tremor was completely gone and he had not developed any side effects.
We get back in the recovery room and he come in and said he had a surprise for me.
So I talked to his wife and she told me his favorite cake was chocolate cake. So over the weekend, we went and got some chocolate cake for him, brought it in and had him cut it. So right there, he can tell his function is returning.
Except for a crooked.
I don't care, that's beautiful.
He is cutting a piece of cake and eating it himself. And when I saw the smile on his face and how he was enjoying that, like that was probably one of the most touching things I've felt as a physician.
Absolutely impossible yesterday.
And today?
Today it just works slicker and quicker.
It's just amazing, the difference that it made. Couldn't believe it, that it happened that fast. Just like they went in and flipped the switch and it went away.
He went from having a tremor that has affected his life for the last 25 to 30 years to not having a tremor in 45 minutes. I think this ushers in a new generation of non-invasive therapies of the brain, for not just for neurological disease, but also for psychiatric diseases.
And we're very excited to have that here at UT Southwestern, which is the first center in the state of Texas doing this. However, it's important to understand that HIFU is not the right treatment for everyone. And that's why at UT Southwestern, our approach is to carefully analyze each patient's tremor and merge that understanding with their own lifestyle and their own activities of daily living to determine what the optimal approach is for each individual case.
I just can't thank those people over at the O'Donnell Brain Institute and UT Southwestern enough about what this meant to me. You just don't understand the difference that this is going to make in my life. So now it's up to me to make the best of it.